my best will to look at it.
Hi, everybody. So today, as everybody mentioned, we're talking about migration to the palette. So first we'll introduce ourselves and whom we are discussing. So I am Mohammed Akhil. I am from Hyderabad. And I have been associated with Drupal from the version 4. Yeah, it's been quite a long journey. We have been working with projects 4, 5, 7, and now it's Drupal 8. And I am currently working for Azure Solutions as a Scrum Master. I am certified Scrum Master from Scrum Alliance. And I am also a technical architect. And I am an active member of Drupal Hyderabad group. And I'm mostly known as Asif Noor in the community. So see it in the open version. Yeah, and I also maintain a few contributor communities. That's a brief about me.
Hi guys, this is Chakrapani. People call me Chakri. I'm from Bangalore. I work as a Drupal architect at Azure Solutions. I've been working with Drupal since 2009. That's Drupal 6. And I'm a proud contributor to Drupal with code as well as with other activities. I lead Drupal Bangalore community. I'm a track chair for contribution track in DrupalCon Asia as well. Other than Drupal, I've been lately integrating with Golang and Elixir. If anybody who is working on Golang or Elixir, I would like to catch up with you. A brief overview of what we'll be covering today.
So we'll basically be discussing on why migrate to Drupal 8 is required actually. We'll touch upon the reasons for migration and what are the points that are required you consider for migrating to Drupal 8. Then secondly, you may be hearing in Drupal mostly about update, upgrade, and then you are calling now migrate. So what are what is the difference between each of these? Why different terminologies are being used? Then the four migration modules that we have support in Drupal 8 currently, we'll touch upon those. Then the contributed modules in, that is going to help us in migrating to the Drupal 8. What are the main contributed modules? We'll touch upon them and we'll basically give you an overview of those. Then the planning. Basically, whenever you say about migration, the most important thing is planning a migration project. So what things that will go in planning a migration project? We'll discuss on that. Then basically how you could do the migration with using just a simple user interface, how you could do the migration. We'll take you through that. And then we'll also discuss about Drush, command line tool for Drupal. Using Drush, how you could do the migration. We'll also touch upon that. And we'll also take you through some of the known issues that we had encountered while doing the migrations. We'll talk about that.
Before we go further, we'd like to know who we are talking to. So, how many of you here are site builders? Okay, that's a lot. Yeah. How many of you are module developers? How many of you worked with migration in Drupal 7? Okay, that came down a bit. Yes. So, how many of you are already familiar with Drupal 8? Okay, far less. Okay, so I think we have a mix of audience over here. So we'll be covering the entire process of migration on what are the modules involved and how we can migrate your site from D6 and D7 to D8.
So the first topic is why migrate to Drupal 8. Yeah, there are quite a few reasons. Firstly, how many of you know that Drupal 6 is reaching its end of life? That's a good thing to know, yeah. See, basically in the community, whenever a Drupal version is released, currently whenever you say Drupal, it refers to the current version. And the current version in the community is 8. And Drupal always supports the current version and -1 version, which means the Drupal core support will only be available to the Drupal 8 and Drupal 7. So the support like security fixes, bugs, updates, anything to Drupal 6 is actually being stopped. Or officially it is going to be stopped in 1 week from now. Yeah, so that means that all the sites which are running on Drupal 6 does not get any more security updates. which means they are vulnerable to security threats. You will not be getting any bug fixes. If there is any fix that you wanted, which you had found in your Drupal core, you would not be getting help, much help from the community. Yeah, that's basically no more support for D6. Now, once again, here basically there are two things. There are people who would be running Drupal 6 sites, there are also people who are running Drupal 7 sites. Now, migration to Drupal 8 is very much recommended for Drupal 6 sites because of the so-called mentioned reasons. Now, for the Drupal 6 sites, there are still three options that you have. One of them is basically like, if you notice, there are few companies, third-party companies, which will be providing you support for Drupal 6. It's a paid support. It's like, since there is no support from the community, there are companies who are doing the business by providing you the support to Drupal 6 core. So from there, you could still be taking the support because you don't see a viable option currently in upgrading or migrating to Drupal 8. So you could still go for that option one. Then the second option is to upgrade to Drupal 7, because from 6 to 7 is like very much already available everything. You could always go with that option. Which anyway, again, if you look at Drupal 7 support, you have available till 2019, which is three years from now on. So that is one option you have. Then the third option is migrate directly to Drupal 8. Our recommended option, we say to recommend to migrate to Drupal 8 is mainly because of the so-called features that are available, one. And secondly, the support to Drupal 8 is longer. It's at least for 6 to 8 years your site could be secured and there is no requirement of maintenance cost that you have to incur again and again. So that is one of the big good options. And when you talk about new features of V8, I think many of you are aware about the in-place edits, the responsive mobile-first design, and then the RESTful services that has been currently supported in core. So there are quite a good features in Drupal 8 that is going to be there. And also here, one thing I would like to mention is the effort to migrate to Drupal 7, upgrade to Drupal 7 or migrate to Drupal 8 is not the same. But then with 10 to 20% of additional effort, if you could spare now, you could directly migrate to Drupal 8 instead of Drupal 7 and can take all the cool features of Drupal 8 as well as keep the site secure. So that is very one of the things.
If you go for Drupal 7, you will have to upgrade again when support ends for Drupal 7 when Drupal 9 comes. So, but if you spend another 10-20% of effort, that is not because of the migration difficulties. The migration is much easier, the core migration. The additional effort would be to migrate your custom and contributed modules, because the Drupal 8 module, you might not find all the contributed modules ready in Drupal 8, but it's worth it. So your site will be secure for next 8 to 10 years.
So coming to these terminologies, and basically update, when we do the updates, in Drupal again you have in versions, like you have major version and then a minor version, like 6.x they say. The X refers to the minor version, whereas 6 refers to the major version. So whenever a security fix has been released or whenever there are updates to the core, a minor version gets incremented. And for updating, you think you basically run an update.php in your Drupal site. That is basically known as an update. Whereas upgrade, basically between major versions, 7 to 8 or 6 to 8, that is all an upgrade. Because the upgrade basically do it whenever there is a change in major version. And Drupal only changes the major version when there is a change to the core. Architecturally, if there are changes made to the core, then only the major version gets changed. Yeah, when you say upgrade, basically it's like in-place code upgrade. Basically what you do is you have a database of your D6 site, you place the Drupal 7 code on top of it, and then run the upgrade of PHP. Migration is not about the code, it's more about the configurations and the contents that you are actually migrating. So basically it means that there is nothing like you could migrate only from 7 to 8 or 6 to 8. You could run from any version, migrate to Drupal 8. Because it's only the content and the configurations that are being imported. And in D8, the only supported method is migration. You don't have an upgrade from D7 to D8. What you could do only is migration.
So with respect to Drupal 8, if we say upgrade or migration, both are interchangeably used. It means migration. There is no in-place upgrade support for Drupal 8.
Look at the kind of modules or the support that we have in core of Drupal 8. If you are looking at Drupal 6 to Drupal 8, what you have is the core. Obviously, the core can be upgraded. Along with that, the CCK. Now, many of you who has worked with Drupal 6 might know that CCK is a contributed module or was a contributed module at that time, which has been got into core in Drupal 7. So, if there are sites running Drupal 6, then you need a support to migrate that CCK modules to Drupal 8. And the support that is already available is CCK, link, email, phone, image caching. All these are directly available with the core migration. So, Drupal 8 core, if you use it and then run the migration, all these can be directly migrated to Drupal 8. And if you are looking at Drupal 7 to Drupal 8 migrations, then basically you could migrate the content, the users, taxonomies, logs, menus, and all this can be directly migrated. When I say this core migration support, basically it means that in the core itself, all these features for migration is available. Now, what if you have to migrate some other things which are not part of the core? Then that's when comes the, let's touch upon first the core migration modules which we are talking about. Migrate, if you had worked with in Drupal 7, if you had done the migration, you had actually a contributed module, which is currently moved to V8 as a core module. It actually provides a framework and an API to migrate the content and configurations. In the next.
Migrate Drupal.
This is actually a Drupal to Drupal migration module. If you have seen a Drupal to Drupal migration module in D7, which actually helps you to upgrade or migrate from one Drupal site to another. This also has been moved to the core. They call it as migrate Drupal, and it again supports to migrate content and configurations.
So, both of these are migration frameworks which are moved into Drupal 8 core, wherein migrate provides the core migration API to migrate Drupal as well as non-Drupal sites to Drupal 8. And the migrate Drupal is something which is built on top of the migrate for Drupal to Drupal migration.
Yeah. So now also look at the contributed modules of Drupal 8, which is going to help us in migration. Yeah. Right. So first, the Drupal upgrade. Yeah, it basically provides you all the tools that is required for you to do and migrate. So if you just install this module and run /upgrade, you could do the migration process. The interface, from the interface basically you could do the migration. You just say /upgrade and you could see the options, what all the migrations that you are going to do. And it also provides support to Drush. Then the second is the migrate tools. Basically, this is also another contributed module, and this actually provides you few additional commands, which you could, once you install this, in the UI you could see more options for the migration, as well as using the Drush also you could do many other options, like you have a status, you could check the status of the migrate, or you wanted to import only a specific migration from DSM to DA, you could specify the migration thing. All those new the commands is going to help you. Without migrate tools, you will not be able to do it. You could just directly migrate without any options. Yeah, next. Then migrate plus, this is another contributed module. Basically, this is more required if you have to write your own custom plugins or migration plugins, because not everything is available for migration. So that is one thing. So this actually extends the core migration framework. The migrate module that we have in the core, you could use that to, use this module to extend the migrate framework, migrate module. It provides you API also for grouping the migration. So when you are running the migrations, you wanted to group few migrations and then run them. Then this is the module that is going to help. And during the migration, since you have been migrating anyway to a new site, you wanted to make few changes before you could migrate. You could manipulate the incoming source data as well. It gives you examples on how you could do it. You could have a look at that. Yeah, then one more module is basically a migrate manifest. It gives you a Drush command. It's basically like you could create a migration template, and then using the Drush, you could run this. Yeah.
So let's have a look at what the migration workflow will be. So initially, you need to prepare for migrating your site, Drupal 6 or Drupal 7 site to Drupal 8. So there'll be a list of steps what you need to do or the planning. So once that is done, you'll be running your migration with UI as well as Drush. You can choose which method you would want to proceed. So once you choose that and run your migrations, so the migration will be run and you will review whether if all the migrations are successfully run or not. So based on the migration messages, you can decide what is the next step is. If everything is fine, you can just, it's done and you can just uninstall all the migration related modules. If it is not, and if you are happy, you can, I mean, if there are still migrations which are missing and it's not complete, you can rerun the migrations. And if you're not happy with the migration process, you can actually roll back your migrations. So we'll see how each of these will be done. So as I mentioned, you'll have two available options. One of them is going with the user interface, where you don't need to worry about the command line or Drush, what we are talking about. You can just use the user interface, and which will be very easy and simple, but it will take a lot of time to run the migrations. Whereas the Drush option is robust and much faster. Yeah, and also allows selective migrations with Drush. That's one important thing to note. And as you know, Drush also requires additional modules. By default, for the running the migrations with user interface, you just need core migrate Drupal modules, and migrate upgrade module, which is also called as Drupal upgrade module. For Drush, you need additional modules like tools and migrate plus or migrate manifest. We'll get in detail. Yeah.
Here actually, when I said about selective migrations, basically when you are able to roll back, you had migrated, but then there are few issues that you had faced. So you had rolled back a few things. Though using Drush, you could select only the specific migration that you wanted to run, and then you could run that. That is going to be, that will be very helpful when you have been migrating and then you are facing issues. Again, you don't need to do the entire migration. It would take a lot of time because you have to import the content, and content is going to be in thousands and sometimes in millions. Yeah.
So executing an upgrade with UI. So you need to install migrate upgrade module, which provides one UI at the path slash upgrade. It also provides one Drush command as well. So for doing an upgrade with UI, you need to install the migrate upgrade module and go to slash upgrade page, where it will ask you for credentials of your legacy database. So if you are planning to migrate your Drupal 6 site, you need to give access to your Drupal 6 site, which can be accessed from your Drupal 8 site. And if you are planning to migrate your Drupal 7, similarly you need to give access to the same database. You don't need to have a complete instance of your legacy site. You can actually keep your just the database in your which is accessible to your Drupal 8 instance, and you can still run the migrations. And in this particular page, in the slash upgrade, it will initially, once you give the database credentials of your legacy DB, so it will check all the available options configurations and give a summary of missing upgrade paths. So we have seen in the earlier screens what are the support which provides, which are provided by the core migrate module. So it will list down all the missing upgrade paths, and it will also list down the summary of available upgrade paths. So which means it will just tell you that these are the migrate paths which I'll be running, and there are a lot of them which are missing. So if you're having a lot of contributed modules in your Drupal 6 or Drupal 7 site, and if you're not having any same modules in Drupal 8 which provide migration plugins, they won't be run. So it will tell that these migrations are missing, but these are the available options which I would go ahead with. So there's the screen of the credentials, where it will ask you for the database details as well as, it's similar to the installation where you give credentials of your database.
But here you just give the migration site where, yeah, from where you want it to be basically migrated, the D6 or D7 site credentials.
So this is a screen where it will tell you missing upgrade paths, if you can see. So all these plugins are missing. These are the available upgrade paths. So that's with UI. There's not much to do there. All you need to do is just go to slash upgrade and give the credentials of your source database and files, and it will just run the upgrade. It will take a lot of time if you have a lot of content in your D6 site. And once it is done, it will just finish in the same page. And if it is not complete, you might need to rerun the upgrades again. So So there's not much to do here as we are talking about. That's exactly why there are a lot of contributed modules.
And here actually if you look at this upgrade, the way you could have a look at is maybe you're not planning for migration right now, but you could still have a simple D8 instance and run this, give the your D6 or D7 side credentials and have an overview of what exactly are missing so that you could see like how much effort it would be required for you to plan and migration. That would give you an idea. Okay, so many paths are still missing. So we had to wait or we had to keep track of if you could do the upgrades or if you can contribute to the Drupal 8 by porting these modules. That is going to help a lot.
Okay, so if you are planning to execute your migration with Drush, you need to install latest Drush. Maybe you can use Composer to get the latest version of Drush. And you need to install migrate upgrade module at least. So this is a contributed module. And also migrate tools if you are planning to run your migrations more than once. Yeah, so there's a in Drush we still have a couple of methods. One is a simple method, so where we'll use migrate upgrade. So this is generally used for migrations with Drupal templates and with a configured source site. So this executes all created migrations and imports content and configurations at once. And if you don't want to run the migrations together, so what you can do is you can initially use the --- configure only option, where it will just create the migrate configurations, but it won't import any content or sites configuration. So you can just create migration configurations, which will give you an overview of what all migrations or what all content and configurations will be imported into Drupal 8 site. So with migrate upgrade, this is the command you can use to migrate all your content from your legacy DB. So Drush migrate upgrade --- legacy DB, where you need to give username and password of the legacy database and the database name. And legacy root is something, if you have a site up which is accessible from your Drupal 8 instance, you can give the URL of the site. So this will be used to pull the files from the public files. So as I said, if you are using --- configure only to create migrate configurations and not importing all the data at once, so you can have a look at what are all the migration paths that are available by using Drush migrate status. So it will give you a list of all possible migrations. You can review and then run migration selectively. So if you have used configure only option, so that will initially create your migrate configurations and then you can choose which migrations to run with the help of command migrate import. Okay. So if you want to run all the migrations, you can use the option --- all. Drush migrate import --- all. This will import all content and configurations at once. If you want to run selectively, so you can just give the migration name there. So Drush migrate import migration name. So if you want to migrate only blocks, you can do so with migrate upgrade. Yeah. So there is a complex method, as I said, so which will involve creating manifest files. So you need to install a module called migrate manifest. So again, the manifest file, yeah, this will look like this. So it's almost similar to migrate upgrade. So what you need to do here is you need to list down all the migrations available in a YAML file, which is called a manifest file. So this is useful if you want to run migrations in groups, as I told. So in the earlier option, you can just run migrations with the available migrate options. Yeah, so you need to create a manifest file. So you can list only the migrations that you want to run at this point in time. So you don't need to list all of them and you don't need to worry about the order. So even if you're listing nodes in front of the and then giving user migrations later on, so the migration will sort in the order of dependencies. If you want to import nodes, it needs user references. So it has to import users first. So the migrate is smart enough and
sort the migrations and run in the dependency order itself. So D6 modules for listed migrations are must. So here in this case, unlike earlier options, we are listing the migration paths in a manifest file. So if you are listing a migration and there is no equivalent D6 module which is enabled in your Drupal site, the migration will fail. So make sure if you are listing a migration, the equivalent module in your legacy system is available. As Drush won't skip the migrations and tries to run everything because you have already specified that you need to run these migrations in the YAML file. Yeah. So this is the Drush command to run the migration, migrate manifest option, Drush migrate manifest legacy DV and the manifest.yaml file. So let's have a look at all the migrate Drush commands and options available. So we have been talking about migrate, upgrade and option. So what are all the different options available with Drush? So migrate, upgrade, this is provided by Drupal upgrade module. And you can use it to upgrade from D7 and D6 to Drupal 8. And this generates migrate configurations from source site content and configuration with the --- config only option, and then runs migrate in proper order. So by default, if you run just migrate upgrade, it will generate the migration configurations as well as run them. And you can also choose to just generate the configurations first and then import the content and configuration. So the options are legacy DB URL, so which is the URL of your legacy database, and DB prefix. So if you are having any table prefixes, you can specify that with legacy DB prefix option. And the legacy root is the URL of your Drupal 6 site. And config only we have seen to generate just the migration configurations. And this also provides a command called migrate status. So this will tell you the status of all the migrations. So we have seen the YAML file. So those are the migrations that will be available. Let's say if you have already run a migration with migrate upgrade and you want to see what is the current status of it. So it will tell you what are the migrations which are in idle state, what are the migrations that are currently importing, and you can have a look at that. And it will also, as you have seen, migrate import is another command that is provided. I think we have seen all this already. Yeah. So the import options are all, group, limit, feedback, ID list, update, and force. So with the migrate upgrade, you can choose to run all the migrations at once, and you can choose to run the migration in groups, and you can limit the number of migrations that you want to run at once, and you can set the frequency as well, and you can put a list of migration IDs.
Actually, using this Drush, you would actually have very good control over the migrations. You could decide on what exactly you wanted to run and what you could skip it for now during the migration. So using the Drush is more recommended if you are basically comfortable with the migration concepts and things, then Drush is the better way to do the migrations.
Do you know what are the equivalent modules?
It's migration tools actually provides you all these commands.
No, I think what I mean is, let us say if we are running the migrations for blocks, you need to make sure that your Drupal 6 site has blocks module enabled. It's the modules I'm talking about. Yes, it's in D6 site you need to have the modules. If you need to run the block related migration, you need to have your block module enabled in D6. In D8, the block module is split into two different modules.
Actually, if you are using a block module and you have been migrating, so you need to actually have the required modules in Drupal 8, because that's what the mapping.
That's another option we'll look at, where when we are using Drupal manifest, you need to have both the modules enabled in Drupal 8. Like if you have a block module, let's say you are importing blocks, for example, in Drupal 6 block is single module, in Drupal 8 there are two different modules, so you need to enable both the modules. So which I think there is a custom block and another one module for the blocks. Yeah, so in Drupal 6 there was only one block module. So it may not be one-to-one mapping when it comes to the modules. For example, if you consider CCK, so there is a module in Drupal 6. In Drupal 8, you don't need a CCK module. So, but if you are migrating fields, you need to have CCK module enabled in Drupal 6. If you disable the CCK module, you won't be able to import fields to Drupal 8. So that's what I mean when I say like you need to enable the required module.
So it's a manual thing, it's not automatic.
No, you not see by default you will already have your module enabled in your Drupal 6 site. Just make sure that you don't disable those modules when you are actually running the migration.
But the tool doesn't tell me that you should enable it.
I can see when you run the /.
See, when you are running with Drush, you will get a lot of errors.
Okay.
So these are the precautions which will help you not go to the error log and then see which failed and where it failed, and it's obviously it will tell you why it failed. Okay, so you have to go back and then enable the module and then.
Basically, the command the migrate messages gives you the list.
So there will be a lot of messages when you are running a migration on a site. There will be huge number of messages. So you need to go through all the messages to find which of them actually succeeded and where it failed.
And also, the /upgrade is going to give you that information at the beginning itself. That what are the missing things and what are the things available. When it says missing, it means that the migration is actually not mapping.
So you can make sure that the particular module is enabled or not. So if you are running a migration and if you are running a migration and let's say it's stuck or something, so Drush has a command for you. You can use migrate stop to stop that particular migration, and the migrate reset status resets the status of your current running migration. So it will reset it to idle. So if you are running a migration and you are stuck and it's not proceeding, you can just use Drush migrate reset status for that particular migration and it will reset the status and you will be able to redo the migration. And migrate messages is something which will help you debug your migration status. So the known issues while running a migration from Drupal 6 to Drupal 8 or so there is a story content type in Drupal 6. So in Drupal 8, it's named as article. So, but it won't import the stories to article. It's treated as a different content type and it will create a new content type called story in Drupal 8. So the article is not touched. So
before we get into this, there's one more thing that we need to understand was when we have been migrating or upgrading from Drupal 6 to Drupal 7, what we used to do was we used to actually configure the required configurations in the Drupal 7 and then you run the upgrades. But here you would not be doing anything. You just have to have a fresh D8 installation site and then run the migrate. So it means it is going to create the required content types, the fields, the CCK configurations, whatever you had done, everything will be done during the migration. That is why it is migrating the content as well as the configurations into the new Drupal 8 site. If you had done anything on the Drupal 8 site before and then if you run the migrations, it is going to override it. So whatever migration you might have done, it all will get lost and it will get overridden.
So the page content type will be migrated to the basic page, and if you see your fields missing, just visit the edit form of your content type and they might be just disabled. So they'll definitely be migrated to Drupal 8. You just need to enable them in the form display of your content type. And the other thing is the image nodes and file fields are not migrated properly when you are running a migration from Drupal 6 to Drupal 8. So the files are migrated, but the files are not mapped to nodes properly. So that's an issue which is still in progress. And with URL aliases, all the URL aliases work perfectly right, but there's one case where if there is a language which is there in your Drupal 6 site and the language is not enabled in your Drupal 8 site, all the URL aliases won't work unless you enable that particular same language in your Drupal 8 site. Once you enable that, all the URL aliases will start working. And another thing is in Drupal 6, there is an option called menu primary source and secondary source. They are no longer available in Drupal 8, so they are not migrated, those variables. And profile categories, if you are using profile categories in Drupal 6, they are not grouped in Drupal 8 when you migrate by default. And in the profile field, allowed values is in Drupal 8 will be the sum of allowed values and current selected values in Drupal 6. It won't be just the allowed values. And date formats. So if you have any custom date formats in Drupal 6, they won't be migrating. So the only available formats in Drupal 8 are default, short, medium and long. If you are using any other formats, it will fall back to the default format. And text and input formats. So if you are migrating all the different text and input formats which were there in your Drupal 6 side, and you don't have the format available in Drupal 8 side, your content will not be visible. So your content is properly migrated to Drupal 8, but you won't see the content in the front end because of the input formats. So what you need to do is either enable the contributed module or custom module which gives you the filter format for Drupal 8, or just go to that particular content and edit and set one of the available input formats. That will solve the issue. A few more issues. There is a daylight savings time issue. In Drupal 6, the methodology which it used to calculate the daylight savings has changed in Drupal 7 and Drupal 8. So when you are running migrations, you might face an issue with daylight savings. So it might not be migrated properly. So you just need to check that. And there is no support for views yet. And it's work in progress. Your views are not migrated. And there's one more issue we have faced, and it's mentioned in the known issues documentation as well. So after your migration, if your homepage loads and you see that your theme is still broken, all you need to do is just go to /user and then come back, it will work. So that's one Drupalism. I'm not sure yet why, yes, but that works. So when you are migrating from Drupal 7 to 8, there are a few known issues. So the blocked IPs are not migrated, and similar to Drupal 6, the menu UI options, the primary source and secondary source variables are not migrated to Drupal 8, and views as usual, and same is the issue with filters, and most importantly the PHP filter module. So it's not there in Drupal 8. So if you have any PHP filters in your legacy database, so they'll not work. So it's strongly recommended not to use the PHP filter again in Drupal 8. So if you still need, you need to install the PHP filter module. So after the migration, if you are happy with the migration, you need to uninstall all the migration modules. And if you're not, you must reroll. Otherwise, you can actually rerun, if your migration has stopped in between and you need to process it. So generally, if you are doing the migration with UI, so you need to actually rerun the migration a couple of times. So here are the documentation. I think the Drupal.org has a very good documentation on how you can actually go ahead with your migrations. Questions? Yeah. Yes, yes.
There is a missing path in the block.
Yes.
So does that mean that blocks in the D7 or won't be imported to the...
Yes, yes.
Okay.
So if you see any migration path missing in your UI screen, that means those migrations won't be done for sure.
But even if it, I think block is, in Drupal core, I guess.
Yes, so you won't get that problem generally.
Okay, yeah.
I'm just taking that as an example.
Okay,
so
yeah.
That you know there's a block, yeah. Which is one module in Drupal 6 and there are two modules in Drupal 8.
Okay, yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, it will work.
Yes, sir?
Yes, it will work by default. Image cache is migrated.
The only issue was with the attachments, the files or the attachment that you use. If you are using those, then the files are going to be migrated, but then the association between the node and the file is missing currently. That is.
If I use
views itself don't get migrated yet. But your image cache, image styles are migrated.
Hello. Sir, your site is migrated D7 to D8.
Okay.
It will meet all security aspects of guidelines of the Government of India, like validations, cross-scripting.
Yes, I think mostly yes.
Because in the D8, validations and encryptions modules are not available. In D7 it is available.
So which modules are we talking about? If it is a contributed module, they might take some time to have a D8 version.
Before we run this migration, basically if you had like 10 modules in Drupal 7 site and then you have migrated to Drupal 8, you need to have those 10 modules available in Drupal 8 as well. Some of them might have been moved to core and it would be available directly. Some of them you had to actually port it, or if it is available already in D8, you had to install them and then do the migration. So if D7 has having 10 modules which is meeting the government policies, then obviously the equivalent D8 modules will do the same, because the functionality will not be changing anywhere. It's just a version that is going to change.
Can it be possible to migrate users?
Yes, by default it will work. So
there will be no issues.
No issues.
So if you are going to have a profile module for this.
Yeah, module. As I said, there are a few issues with the profiling fields, but otherwise all the users will be migrated successfully.
Only with the users we will not be having any problem. But if they are users and then there is a profile module configured with an user,
yes.
And then there is thing, they have to refer to that known issues section. There is few things that is still there and work is happening.
So is it good idea to move first to the Drupal 6 side to Drupal 7, then migrate it to Drupal 8?
No, we strongly recommend to directly migrate it to Drupal 8, as we mentioned earlier. So one of the important thing is that Drupal 8 has a lot of new features. So if you're migrating it to Drupal 7, you'll have to again migrate it to Drupal 8 or wait until Drupal 9 comes. That's one. And the effort is almost same. The only additional effort you will see while moving to Drupal 8 is because of the lack of contributed modules.
Okay, so you have specified about migrate_upgrade. So that is a command as well, and it's a module as well, right?
Yes, it's a module which provides UI as well as a brush command.
Oh.
Yes.
And obviously you have to do an analysis before you decide on whether you wanted to go with D8, because if your site is using a lot of contributed modules, then one of the suggestions is to go with D7, because not all the modules has been ported to D8 yet. But if there is not many contributed modules, then the recommendation is to put in the effort to migrate to D8 directly, then doing it to D7.
Is there any kind of support available for migrating custom modules? Symfony has been accepted as a code base for Drupal 8.
You were saying support for custom module migration.
Yeah, does that process have to be done manually or
Yes. What you need to do is you need to create custom migration plugins. So if you see some contributed modules, you will see there will be migration plugins within the module directory. So you'll need to write a similar plugin for your custom modules as well.
And also there is one contributed module, I think Drupal 14, some contributed module was there, which is actually going to help you to migrate your module or upgrade your module from D7 to D8.
Sir, but the list of the migrating Drupal 6 to Drupal 8, a known issue is too high. But if I migrate to Drupal 7 first, okay. And the content will be migration will be easier. Only the block content, the views will be available if I migrate to Drupal 7. Will be available in Drupal 8. So in that case, most of the configuration will be saved. Manual work will be saved later on.
Okay, it's not what it means. So when I say the support for migrating views is not available, your views are not directly migrated to Drupal 8. So there's a lot of work which is happening to provide support for views.
So we should wait for...
Maybe you can wait for a couple of months, but getting views into Drupal 8, I don't think it will take a lot of time. It's just that it's not done with a click. So you can still get it done, but the thing is there is no full support. It's still not complete.
See, maybe the D6 to D8, the issue list looking to be quite big, but if you actually go through those points, they are very minor ones.
Yes.
And only any Drupal developers could spend few times, they could actually solve that and can give it as a patch as well.
So definitely that's where we are mentioning there will be a little more effort when you are actually migrating to Drupal 8. But if you compare it in the long run and with the benefits that you will get with Drupal 8, it's definitely recommended to migrate it to Drupal 8.
And sir, what about the features module that we built to from local to server? So we use the features to import export and import configuration to server. So what about that?
So you will be happy to know that you don't need features anymore with Drupal 8, because Drupal 8 has its own configuration management.
And it's
so everything is handled in core itself.
Yeah.
Yeah. So you are saying? Yes. Right, right. See, when you actually choose between UI and Drush, there is a recommendation you can actually go with Drush. Yeah. Okay, so if you know that you need to run your migration selectively, then I'd suggest go with a manifest where you can actually choose your migrations and just run one by one. So just run the migrations of users first and maybe blocks, and then you know validate them properly like that. So if you want to run everything at once, you can directly go ahead with a migrate import. Okay. Okay. Yeah. So that's exactly what I'm talking about. If you know what you are doing, then you can actually try migrate manifest. Because in migrate manifest, you are telling migration API to run these migrations. So you are telling that these are the migration I want to run. But in the migrate import option, it will tell you what are the options available. You are just picking what I want to run. That's the difference. That's what I was trying to tell you. So with migrate manifest, you need to have more control over your migrations, but that is suggested only if you know what you are doing. Mm-hmm. Yes. Okay. See, if you have actually added fields with custom modules, you need to write custom plugins to migrate data of custom fields from D6 to D8. So generally, if it is with the UI you have added and not with the custom modules, they'll get migrated.
Could be some issue.
Yeah.
I mean, otherwise, actually, you should migrate.
The core migration supports fields, so it migrates.
It should not be a problem, actually. If it has not migrated, then maybe some other issue.
Yeah.
Me? We had actually worked with
manifest
as
well. Yeah. Yeah, it works, of course. Yeah. Yeah.
Okay, so my question is, first of all, if I am using the front-end migration, okay. Using the deployer, okay? In that case, is it progressive or it's a complete one-time migration? Let's assume I have millions of content or thousands of content.
See, okay. If you have a lot of content, we strongly recommend to use Drush.
Yeah, in terms of Drush also, whether it will be progressive or...
Yes, it will be progressive, yes.
That's where we have the... That's basically where you have these commands to stop or then look at the migrate messages.
So
and
you don't need to worry that it might break down in the middle. So it's the migration API is smart enough. So even the best part is you can do a migrate upgrade. I mean, meaning, let's say I'm running migration right now, and let's say my site is in production. And there will be a lot of content that is getting added to my Drupal 6 production site. I'll take 1 month to configure my Drupal 8 and run all the migrations. There'll be some content which is added to your Drupal 6 site, right? So with Drush option, you can just rerun your migration. It will check what is the new content that is being added and what is the old content that is already migrated. And it will only migrate the new content. Not only that, it will also identify the content that is updated. So not just the old and new content, it will also identify the updated content. So if you have updated any of the content in your Drupal 6 site from the previous migration to this migration, it will identify and update that content as well.
Yeah,
so it is safe to say that it is a progressive migration.
Yeah, that's pretty cool. Okay, next thing is, as you mentioned that you have already migrated a couple sites in 6 to 8. So if I'm asking, if I have a site with 1,000 of content, only,
okay.
Then how much time it will take to migrate on an average basis?
See, 1,000 is actually hardly nothing. With the UI, it could take, with 1,000, I'm really not, it'll be quick. It'll be very quick. Yeah, not more than 1 hour.
Because if I need to provide some estimate to my customer or anything, so
no,
on an average time, if there is no failure, then what will be the time?
Okay.
See, the thing here you had to understand was it's not about the content that is you have to migrate, but it's also, it's more about the customization that you had done in your D6 site, which also required to be ported over to the D8. If they are just content and with the normal available modules which already you have in D8, then it's very simple migration. There will hardly any effort that will be involved. You could either run with Drush or you could run with slash upgrade. It will be completed in a day or two with testing, you could plan it. But if there are more customization that has been done, then you need to plan an effort of how much it would require for us to write and custom migration plugins in order for it to get it into the D8. That is something depends on the kind of customizations we have done.
So for 1000 or 50,000 rows, it will actually, the estimates won't change, your effort won't change.
Oh.
It's just a little more additional time, maybe 1 hour for Drush to run, that's it.
So basically my question was, why I asked this question, where we have a running site where the single content type have approx 150 fields, okay. And the number of data is more than 4 lakhs. Okay. And in normal insert and edit, we are taking is taking too much time. It's 1 minute per one content approx.
Yeah.
So
see,
if I'm going to migrate that site, then what should I think? What should I take care? And how can I convince my customer that
Again, it will still be the same. But the only thing is how much time the migration will run. Your work will be same otherwise. It could be just that it might take half a day maybe, max. So to run the migrations. If everything else is done correctly. So the important thing is, do you have all the modules configured correctly? Like, do you have the migration paths for all your contributed and custom modules?
See,
so that's where
the estimation has to be based on the customizations and not based on the amount of content that you have.
Yes.
Irrespective of 4 lakhs content, what you have to realize here is the 150 field that you had mentioned. That is actually the most critical part.
Yes.
That we have to
that 150 field is normal, a single node type, in normal article type I have created that field. There is nothing that I have written a custom part.
But actually, it's not recommended anywhere to create 150
is huge, but yeah.
It
should not be creating that custom part.
Yeah. Yes.
I have a Drupal 7 site.
Okay.
And I have a custom theme,
mm-hmm.
which uses TPLs.
Okay.
If I migrate to D8, what will happen to the themes?
Okay, so the migrate process won't help you with your templates.
You have to actually take care of porting your
theme
from
to Drupal.
You have to create
new,
fresh.
So the migrate process will only migrate content and the configuration.
Yes.
So the porting of modules, themes, everything has to be done separately manually.
Okay, thank you. Yeah.
Here.
Drupal 6 and Drupal 7, same site.
Okay.
Drupal 6 and 7 with lot of contributed modules.
Okay.
Okay. Content, everything.
Mm-hmm.
Most of them are customized.
Okay.
Like, which will be faster? D6 to D8 or D7 to D8? Same, everything is same, content, everything.
Then are you asking about the
okay. So you
one
have
will be faster
D6
in migration?
Site and D7 site both? D6 and D7 are the same.
I mean,
amazing.
Content ways and customization ways, both of them are same.
See, one thing I can say is, so one is Drupal 7, you still have support, so you can still wait, that's one option. The other thing is, when we are actually building a migration patch, so 6 to 7 is considered priority, because in another 4 days, you lose support for Drupal 6. Drupal 6 sites won't have any support after that. So it's Drupal's responsibility to provide migration paths from 6 to 8. So if you actually get all your contrib modules and core modules and have a table and look at 6 to 8 and 7 to 8, you will first get support from 6 to 8 and then 7 to 8. So it's safe to say that you will find a lot of D7 modules which doesn't have migration paths, but you will find the same for D6. But you can wait for some more time because you already have a Drupal 7 site and then you can migrate them. That will be better.
How difficult it is to write a custom migration
plugin? It's not really difficult. It involves, let's say, 3 steps. So what you need to do is you need to define the configurations where you need to specify what is your source for the data. and how it has to be processed and what type of field it is. Let's say it's a text or not, or type of the field you need to define, and then the process, and also you need to define the destination. So in your Drupal 8, what is it? Let us say it is CCK in Drupal 6, and it is a field of type, let us say iframe. There was a module called iframe, okay? So it provides a field whose type is iframe. In Drupal 8, it is just a link, okay? So what you need to do is, you need to specify the source, which is your, and type is iframe. Then how do you want to process it? What is the data you need to retrieve from it, and how you want to store it in your Drupal 8 side? But it's a simple example. It depends on your what you have in your Drupal 6.
So it will be YAML files, I guess.
Yes, right. So I think the module you should be using should Migrate Plus. It has examples for simple custom migrations as well as advanced custom migrations with inline comments. So there's a nice documentation within the sample code on what it does.
Yeah, in D7 migration, migration have few drawbacks. Means that the file multilingual file field migrations are doesn't support in D7. So is that resolved in D8?
Yeah, actually, the files there's an issue. As I mentioned in known issues, the file attachments are not linked when you actually migrate. No. So you're saying file, okay, you are talking about PO files, is it?
Multilingual file
fields.
PO
files. See, it's considered as file attachments at one level.
Yes.
So the file attachments themselves are actually not linked in Drupal 8. So when you actually migrate, those files are migrated, but they are not actually attached to the node itself. So there's an issue which is being worked on. That's one. And there's some issue with multilingual content as well. So the multilingual content doesn't have full support yet. But I think we need to look into the issue queues and what's the progress. See, most of the issues I'm talking about, all of these are work in progress.
See, actually here, the D8 has a 100% multilingual support. The only issue was when you're migrating the multilingual content from a legacy to the Drupal 8, there is an issue that is still being worked on.
So Migrate Plus allows us to move from one
Actually, the migrate module of Drupal 8, the core, is built to migrate from any of the legacy system to the Drupal 8. It's, whereas the migrate upgrade is specifically from Drupal to Drupal.
So in Migrate 6, you find example code for how to build a custom plugin. So you can use that to migrate.
So you, as you specified, we could migrate the content and configuration. So would it be possibility that where we are not able to migrate some of the third party configuration from D6 or D7 to D8? Means, is there any possibility where we exclude some of the third party configurations?
What do you mean by third party configuration?
Just like if suppose we are using some email servers and we don't want to migrate those configurations from D6 or D7 to D8.
That's where the selective migrations you could use.
Yes.
It and skip those particular things from the migration file.
Okay. Yeah. Thanks.
Okay, then thank you.
Thank you.